Someone said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, in Psalms, the 100th chapter of Psalms, the first verse, it says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can you make a joyful noise for the Lord this morning?
I'm going to ask you to please stand with more. I hate to bug you, but let's stand in the reverence of God's word this morning. Vamos a ponernos de pie una vez más en reverencia a la palabra de Dios. Voy a estar leyendo el libro de San Marcos, capítulo 10, versículo 44 y 45.
We just lost his brother Muhammad Ali. Everybody knows Muhammad Ali. He said, service to others is the rent you pay for your room here on earth. Think about that. Muhammad, now his wife is taking over his foundation on service. And that really stood out to me, but I'm gonna end with this. And my grandfather said this to me, and it's interesting that I'm here now talking about service, because, you know, being a good citizen on earth as well as within your church. But he says, everyone, well, he quoted the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. Everyone can be great because everyone can serve. You don't have to have a college degree to serve. You don't have to make your subject and your verb agree to serve. You only need a heart full of grace and a soul generated by love. Thank you.
Of patience from the Western Dictionary. Western Dictionary's meaning says, it's the quality of being patient as the bearer of misfortune or pain when confronted with delay without complaint. So keep that definition in mind. And in Greek dictionaries, it means to have fortitude, to persevere, to abide, to endure. It even means to take. It means continuous and wait. Patient, we are born again Christian because God is the God of patience. So now I want to just turn your attention briefly to our true example, and that's Jesus. Remember the story when Jesus visited Martha's house and he was busy teaching, and Martha was, you know, concerned about the preparation that she has to make. And one translation says, she just bursted in and said, Lord, don't you mind that my sister has left me to do everything by myself? Tell her to get up and help me. Oh, I can really see how patient Jesus was. He is teaching, and here come Martha bursting in. Listen how Jesus handled the situation. He said, Martha, my dear, you are worried and bothered about so many things. But one thing is needful. And Mary has chosen the best part. She sat at Jesus' feet.
All right. All
listening
right.
to what he said.
Yeah.
And that's how you and I can be patient. We have patience, but that's how we can be patient by listening to his words. Things, patience, their patience, being patient, can come up a little higher. I want you to stand to your feet. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. Learning patience, can be a difficult experience, but once conquered,
my life
will be easier.
Is the joy of giving as a servant. And the Webster's Dictionary describes a servant as one who renders obedience and worship to God. And a serve is to make ready and to pass out. My scripture for serving is Romans 12 and 1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is our reasonable service. Amen. I certainly appreciate the food ministry and all that you do.
Amen.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Lord.
Everybody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God. God is good.
All the time.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Amen.
We will rejoice and we will be glad in this day.
Amen.
Praise God. Sister, go ahead and you say, I have an hour.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We thank God for everyone that's here today.
Amen.
We just thank God so much for everybody participating in the food ministry. It is a great ministry.
Amen.
Praise God. And my subject today is the strength in unity as a servant. And my first thoughts was, what is a servant of God? Servant of God, that's what we are. And I thought about it, I looked at it, and I said, okay, the first thing is to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and your Savior. We're born again Christians.
Amen.
We're a servant of God. So that makes us servant of man.
Amen.
Okay? What we do is to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of our lives, to speak God's life to people that we come in contact with. God's life and not death. Amen?
Amen.
Okay? To let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Because we are the light. The Bible said we are the light of the world. Okay. We don't want to hide our light. People can see this when you, and I see it in the food ministry where they're just giving food out and everybody is smiling and happy. And the people that are receiving the food, they just feel very comfortable. I mean, it's almost like they just enjoy coming out there and being around the people of God. That is the way it should be.
Amen.
That's the way it should be. We do this in joy. And I know I've had a lot of fun with Sister B early morning, going over there at Whole Food, and she's buzzing at me and telling me stuff, and we just have fun.
Amen.
You know, long time. I'm not as involved in it now because I have a job, but I'm still there available when they need me.
Amen.
Okay, and also we are to bear with each other. Sometimes, you know, when you're working and you're working hard and a lot of people working, we can get our own emotions can kick in, but we're to bear with each other and forgive and to put on love, which is the bond of perfect unity. All right, in Psalms 100 verse 2 tell us, we are to serve the Lord with gladness, to be glad. People can see that when you're out there and you're doing something and you're happy. They don't feel like, you know, oh, I hate to be doing this or whatever. And I see this in us. And I know I've heard in the past that I believe Whole Food has said things like how happy they are that Logos is a part of this ministry.
Amen.
But doing things in love. That's what we do at Logos. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. It's And my subject was the strength in unity as a servant. And we know that it's much easier for four people to pick up a 200-pound box than it is for one. Amen.
Mi parte fue esta.
So my part was this.
El galardón, digamos.
The reward of selflessness.
De negarse a sí mismo en el servir a Dios.
In serving the Lord.
¿Cuáles serían nuestros galardones?
What will be our reward?
Lo que yo estaba mirando en el video.
So what I was watching in this video.
Yo nunca he podido venir a ayudar al Ministerio de Mujeres.
I've never been able to come and help with the women's
Pero
ministry.
Lo que yo miré.
But what I saw.
Lo que escuché.
What I heard.
Es lo que yo hago en otras partes.
It's what I do in other parts.
Como misionera.
As a missionary.
Amen.
Lo que ellos hacen es un trabajo misionero.
And what they do is the missionary work.
Localmente.
Locally.
Es mucho trabajo.
It's a lot of work.
El gozo,
the joy,
la fuerza,
the strength,
la paciencia,
the patience,
todo se perfecciona cuando eres un servidor de Jesucristo.
It's all perfected when you're a servant of Christ Jesus.
Filipenses 2 y 3 dice.
Philippians 4, 2 says.
2 y 3.
2 and 3.
Nada hagáis por contienda o por vanagloria.
Do nothing in vanglory.
Pero bien con humildad.
But rather with humbleness,
estimándose unos a otros,
caring for one another,
como superiores a él mismo.
As superior to yourself.
Miras a las personas.
See the people.
Como que son superiores a
ti. I see they're superior to you.
Los miras como es que una alma de Dios.
You see them as a soul of God.
Dice, no mirando cada uno lo suyo propio.
Not looking at each other's things.
Sino cada cual también por lo de los otros.
But rather to look at others.
La palabra selflessness.
The word selflessness.
Es negarse a sí mismo.
It's to neglect yourself.
Negarte a ti mismo y mirar por los demás.
To neglect yourself and see others.
¿Cuál es tu galardón?
Look out for others. What is your reward?
Cuando sirves al Señor de esas maneras.
When you serve God in such manner.
No se puede explicar el sentir.
You cannot explain the feeling.
Es un gozo inexplicable.
It is a joy unexplainable.
Es una bendición.
It is a blessing.
Cuando tienes el conocimiento de Dios.
When you have God's knowledge.
Que cuando tú estás sirviendo.
That when you are serving.
Dios está bendiciendo a alguien más.
God is blessing someone else.
A través de ti.
Through you.
Tú eres esa guía.
You are that guide.
A través de ti.
Through you.
Dios está bendiciendo.
God is blessing.
Dios está dando una bendición.
God is giving a
Dios blessing. Está salvando almas.
God is saving
Dios está
souls.
Dando una palabra de
God
ánimo.
Is giving a word of courage.
He escuchado que algunos de ustedes hasta han orado por personas que vienen por comida.
I've heard that some of you even pray for those
personas
who come to give food.
A Jesús.
Some people have received Jesus.
Ha sido una bendición.
It has been a blessing.
No esperando nada a cambio.
And waiting for nothing in return.
Trabajando duro.
Working hard.
Sabiendo que Dios está usándote.
Knowing that God is using you.
Mira lo que dijo Pablo.
Let us see what Paul said.
Pablo fue un hombre que sufrió mucho.
Paul was a man that suffered
trabajó
much.
Mucho.
He worked hard.
Tuvo que lidiar con mucha gente.
He had to deal with a lot of people.
A un montón de siervos.
To advise many servants.
Dijo, he peleado la buena batalla.
He said, I have fought the good fight.
Segunda de Timoteo 4,
2 Timothy 4, 7.
He peleado la buena batalla.
I fought the good fight.
He acabado la carrera.
I have finished the race.
He guardado la fe.
I have kept the faith.
He guardado la fe.
I have kept the faith.
Todo lo que importa.
Everything that matters.
Es que guardes tu fe.
It is that you keep your faith. Why?
Porque por lo demás me guarda, dice Pablo.
Because Paul says.
Me está guardando la corona de justicia.
That he's keeping my crown of faith.
La cual me dará el Señor.
Which the Lord will give me.
Juez justo.
Which is just.
En aquel día.
In those days.
No solo a mí, dice él.
Not only to me, he
sino
says,
también a todos los que le aman su venida.
But also those that love his coming.
Sirvámosle al Señor
Let
con
us
amor,
serve God with love.
Con paciencia.
With patience.
Hasta que él regrese.
Until he comes back.
Dios los bendiga a todos.
May God bless you all.
Ministry. It's bigger than just giving away food. But I want to just thank you for your service. And I want to thank you in behalf of heaven and let you know that your name is known. Praise the name of the Lord. And God is pleased with the work that you're doing. I want you to be encouraged in the work of the Lord.
Amen.
Again, I thank Sister Catherine for affording and for carrying out, for being obedient to carry out what the Lord had laid on her heart. And I just thank God for you. And I say to you today that because of this service, I don't know, it's something about acknowledgement. I believe that we can see ourselves in the work of the Lord. And when we do, we get a result. The Bible says that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. We praise God for this great church. We thank God for the food ministry. We thank God for those that have been honored today. Tribute to whom tribute is due. We thank God for Sister Catherine having the conviction and the to do and put forth the program. It's been good. Praise the Lord. The message has already been preached. Praise God. I didn't even talk to anyone during the course of preparation. Much of the messaging has already come forth. Praise God. I just like to say that I'm honored with this church in the way that it has carried out their mission in serving the people. I have seen other environments. I've seen an occasion where there were individuals that came in a car with family and asked for food and were turned away because the day that they were coming was not the day for their area that they lived in. Praise the name of the Lord. But I thank the Lord for this ministry. I thank God that they seem to capture the heart of God. They give without partiality. And Father God, we just thank you today for all that's been said and done. We give you praise and we give you glory. We just thank you so much. We just thank you for blessing the sharing of your word right now. A few characteristics that exemplify the work that's going on here is a work of compassion, a desire to meet and impact the needs of others, not considering themselves. Thank God for Brother John. What he said was powerful. Talking about loving without barriers and boundaries. The heart of a servant is to esteem and to the privilege to serve. Not for recognition, not for vain glory. Esteeming the needs of others far greater. I'd like to read a scripture for your hearing. It's found in 1 Corinthians the chapter 12, verse 28. I want to say that the food ministry has heaven's approval on it. I know it is. Because Jesus himself said, I was hungry and you gave me bread. He said, I was sick and you visited me. Talk about in prison and you came to see about me.
Amen.
So it's God's plan that the church reaches out and touches. This ain't a ministry for the timid, is it?
Amen.
It's a ministry. Some ministries, I believe, when I go into care facilities, convalescent facilities, I look at people that are just doing it for the money. It ain't the kind of ministry that you just do for the money. You got to have a heart of compassion for the people. Much of Jesus' ministry was spent in ministry to food. Food was a big part of it. Did you know that food can get you to a point where you can give an individual spiritual food if you take care of that natural? Somebody said the way to win a man a lot of times is through his stomach. You ever heard that expression?
Yes.
Praise God. Food have a whole lot to do with people getting in preparation to hear the word of the Lord.
Amen.
I've heard some stories about what goes on here. I've heard people talk about things concerning their homes, and I've heard people get answers. I've heard about people getting delivered from sickness.
Amen.
I've heard some stories about this place.
Amen.
I've heard some stories about the leaders of Logos Family. I heard that they do things from the heart and not from their head.
Amen.
I believe that's what God is pleased with. My responsibility today as a minister to come before you is to encourage you and to let you know that what you're doing is a great thing in the sight of God. To let you know that your name is known. Heaven is mentioned in your name.
Amen.
It's not a small matter in the sight of God. It's large, it's big, it's gigantic. I'm looking at Matthew, the 25th chapter, in the 35th verse, and it says, and when the evening his disciples came to him saying, this is a desert place, and the time is now past. Send the multitude away that they may go into the villages and buy themselves victuals. But Jesus said unto them, they need not depart, give them to eat. He did not want to send the people away hungry. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and 28, it says, and God has set some in the church, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, the gifts of healing, helps and governments, and diversity of tongues, helps. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to just say to the food ministry, those that are in leadership and those that are helpers, you, your hand, your arm is the arm of this church. And what you're doing, you're effecting the entire environment with what you do. The church responsibility is to reach out. We are to be disciples to our community. We are to give. And giving what you are doing, you are expressing the heart of God. Praise the name of the Lord. It is the work of the Lord that you're doing.
Yeah.
And you should be encouraged. And you should be glad. And you should know that what you're doing has heavenly significance.
Yeah.
Because of you, many that work with you have learned the ministry of what it means and those that are part of. I declare to you today that there shall be a greater anointing in the work that you are doing, in the work that you're carrying out. I declare to you today that there will be individuals that will come, that will receive healing because of being in your presence. I declare to you that miracles will come forth, that this will be a different food ministry, that this will be a ministry that is evident and has God's consent and God's approval, and that you will be effective and people will look and wonder, what kind of ministry is this? What is it that I'm getting? It's bigger than just food, is what I'm declaring to you today. And we thank the Lord for you right now. We give God the glory for your commitment. I thank God, Jesus, he learned obedience. In Hebrews, the 5th chapter, it says, though he were a son, yet he learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. For a long time, and I'm almost closed, I used to take my mother around to visit sick people. And when I'd take her, she would get in there and she would clean their houses. She would even clean them up. She would cook food. Sometimes she'd cook at their house, but most of the time she'd bring food. And I remember once I was preparing for a message, and the Lord gave me this scripture in Hebrews, the 5th chapter and the 8th verse. It says, though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. And the Lord showed me something as I was preparing to minister a sermon. He said, now Ralph, the reason why you have a heart and a conviction for things and going to the hospital, I do that. I go to jails, I do that. He said, it's because of the experience that you had with your mother. And so I learned something about this. I was looking at that scripture and it said he learned obedience by the things which he suffered. Obedience. But I heard that the word obedience is interchangeable with experience, by the things that he experienced. I learned that from being with my mother. I had experienced that. And so what's happening here is that those that are in charge, what you're doing, you're training people. This is a training. That's why I need you to see it. It's bigger than just giving away food. What you're doing, you're influencing people. You're teaching people. And as a result of it, they have a better relationship even in their homes.
Yeah.
It's great what you're doing. So I salute you. I'm proud of you. This church is proud of you. Godspeed to you. God bless you. And thank you for your time.
For the food ministry. I love all of them. I know that God loves them and they're doing a wonderful job. And I just want to dedicate this song to you to say, Jesus, Jesus, how I trust you. Because when I was writing the letters to Safeway and everybody to get help, I told them most of these people we're celebrating are senior citizens. But we love them. We appreciate what they do. And you know, God don't forget us. I'm a senior citizen too. God doesn't. He doesn't forget us when we get old. He said, be not faithful unto death. So the song say, Jesus, Jesus, how I trust you, how I prove you day by day.
Yes.
Oh, Glory to God. At this time, we're going to have Jamila Stanford come for a moment of sharing this morning.
There's going to be a video following this, and Sister Catherine, I wasn't able to. It's Jamila, and I've been with the food pantry from the beginning. I'm responsible. I'm on the back end. I just do all the paperwork and so forth. So I think all of the volunteers, I think we should recognize them. My role is very small, and I don't think they deserve recognition, but in my opinion, like people like my mom, who goes every single day to pick up food, unload boxes, my mom, Brother Victor, my Kate, my Joel, they are there 5 days a week. And so I just appreciate all of them. There's so many other people. And again, my role, I just handle the paperwork and I set it up initially and that's it. So,
Jamila does a lot more. She didn't share
everything she does. There's a lot of paperwork that she does in order to get the items and the food. And every year, the toy ministry, she's responsible for that. You get your bikes and all that, the toys, she is responsible for that. So she's being modest. Praise the Lord, and we will just... volunteers. So I'm going to be calling the names, and I would like to please come forward. And this reads, excellence. We express our sincere appreciation, and then it has a name, and it says, in recognition of your personal commitment, dedication, and performance to the Lord. Amen. So if I call your name, please come forward. Thank you, volunteers, for all your hard work. Yes. And let me tell you, it's hard work. I volunteered for 2 years, but it is also very rewarding to be able to feed our people, like Sister was saying, physically, but also spiritually. We can share the word of God and the love of God to those that are in need. Yes. So we thank you so much for all your hard work, and please accept this with a sincere heart of appreciation.
so we want everyone to participate. We thank the Lord for this service today. We thank the Lord for Sister Catherine, the things that God has laid on her heart, and it comes to pass. And thank the Lord for all the workers. And truly, it's a blessing. You have been a tremendous blessing in the lives of many, many individuals. And so we just thank the Lord for each and every one of you today. Before we dismiss, I want to say this. Is there anyone here that said, I need to receive Jesus Christ, or I love to receive Jesus Christ as my Savior? If that's you, just lift your hands. We want to take time to pray for us. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the service today. We thank you for these, your people. Thank you for the Word of God. We thank you for the volunteers and in this outreach that you have given unto us. And we give you glory and honor and praise. And we thank you for the food we're about to receive. We ask that you bless it and sanctify it for the nourishment of our bodies. In Jesus' name, amen.